than others. Respect is something you cannot buy. McDonald's doesn't sell respect. We have to earn it. You want to be respected? You also have to give it. So how does it start? Are we at home? Him or her? No, it starts with yourself. It starts with the self. You have to have respect for yourself to be able to have respect for others and to be respected. More women die in Auschwitz-Birkenau than men did, and the reason for that was they were mothers, or they were pregnant. My father was healthy. He was 48. He was sent to slave labor camp, a man's concentration camp in Germany, Buchenwald. And that's where my father died. He only lived 6.5 months. He died of starvation. Now we are old enough in here to know that people die. People die of old age, natural causes. Some people die of disease. And some people die of unfortunate accidents. And in time we learn to deal with those losses. What I have not yet been able to deal with, 11 million people died. What was the cause? Alzheimer's, a heart attack, an automobile accident, a snowmobile. The cause was hate. Hate that silenced the voices of 11 million people, and that is not acceptable. How many of you here say to another person, I hate you? Can you show me that list? I know you do it. I've seen many adults and heard them. However, I accept the fact that you're shy. But when you have the urge to say to someone, I hate you, here is what I would like you to do. Please, stop. And think about a victim your age that died because that person was hated. Your own age. Don't be preoccupied with yourself. Life isn't about the capital I. Life isn't about me. It's about we. One people together. Yes, I'm aware of the fact that there are 6 different races, and we are very occupied with all of them, to the point that we keep forgetting one race, the human race. No matter what we look like, where we came from, or who we pray to, we are part of that one race, the human race. In 2007, I visited Buchenwald because I needed to walk the ground my father last walked. My father and I had huge challenges. And what did I learn from those challenges? I learned that challenges don't hurt us if the choices we make, how we deal with them. I don't get along with my old man, so when I'm older, I'm going to go here or there, well, I have news for you. You can't run away from the self. Wherever your journey is going to take you, you're going to take yourself with you. We have challenges. We need to work them out at a time where we are at. Because you're going to have them. When we are young, we had lots of challenges, various times. When we get older, we also have challenges. The only time we don't have challenges anymore, then we pass on. Two young female prisoners were to begin a new journey, slave labor camp. Germany. Where did they take us? Well, a city called Düsseldorf. Where did they dump us? In a field. In a field where grass didn't grow and there were no buildings. They put up pop tents, the kind of pop tent you put over a picnic table, so your food wouldn't get wet. It was okay for us to be there. 4:30 in the morning, they started to count us to see if anybody ran away, because it was an open field. And then they marched us down to the river, where freight ships used to come in, and we had to unload bricks. Piled them up high on the banks. A few weeks later, 520 prisoners were taken to the capital of the Rhine, Essen. My sister and I were among them, and that was a blessing, because we were fed in the factory, and not by the Nazis. And they had a sub camp. They had barracks, they had bunks, they had a kitchen and water. It didn't last very long. Late summer of 1944, the Allies were bombing very heavily. Daytime, nighttime, anytime. And one day they made us halt near the sidewalk because the air raid sounded, the planes are coming. I overheard a little boy, maybe 6 or 7 years of age. He was calling his mom. Come and see, the idiots are coming. I am 89 and I've not yet seen an idiot. You know why? There isn't one. I've seen people that are challenged, but I've never seen an idiot. Maybe God will spare me for another 89, I might see one. So far I've not yet seen one. But what I learned that morning, that little boy had a good teacher. And I'm not talking about the grade 1 or grade 2 teacher. That's not the teacher I'm talking about. Never, ever is a child born racist. Never. Racism is a learned attitude. When children learn preschool, they bring into school and out to the street. Whether it's here or 4,000 miles away, it doesn't matter. Children learn by example. Preschool. You don't learn those things from your teacher. And now we're into October 1944, the third week of October. And we had a very big surprise when we got back to the camp. Everything had burned to the ground. That day the Allies had thrown small little bombs called phosphorus bombs as they fall, they ignite and spread like wildfire. All the buildings were made out of wood and they burned to the ground. So now we are left with fear. Why? We didn't know what they were going to do to us. It's night time. Well, they found a place where they put us for the winter. They had no problem with it. And what was that? a root cellar, a hole in the ground. That hole was dug down underneath the kitchen. Just dirt taken out. There was some straw down there. That's where they stored vegetables. And we were to sleep on the straw, like pigs. And what happened down there? The straw started to rot. Because those young female prisoners did not go outside after it got dark. By that time, we were aware of those bullies, pastime activities, rape. They didn't come into that hole because the sanitary conditions were appalling. The straw was used as a toilet. No water and no toilet paper. And now we have a new challenge, body lice. Now, I knew of head lice, but I've never heard of body lice. And also, maybe to 1945, there is snow on the ground. And we're still marching to work. What were the conditions? We had no shoes. We had no socks. And we had no underwear. We were dirty and we were wet. We had wooden clubs on our feet that didn't fit. And that's how we marched to work from one end of the city to the other. In the factory we heard rumors they're going to take us away. And the reason for that was the Russian forces were coming closer to that part of Germany. They did not want us to be free, so they took us away, and that was the final journey. Bergen, Bergen.